Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from Educates.tv and today we are going to see how to control our Raspberry Pi board remotely using our desktop computer, laptop or smartphone and the SSH protocol. Without any further delay, let's get started. So far, when we wanted to use our Raspberry Pi, we were using a keyboard, a mouse and a monitor via the HDMI port or a touchscreen like this one. The second method is easier and portable. I have prepared a detailed tutorial on that touchscreen display a few weeks ago. You can check it out. But if we want an even easier solution, we can use our desktop computer or laptop or even our cell phone to remotely control the Raspberry Pi. Check this out. I am running a terminal on my Android cell phone and I can execute commands on my Raspberry Pi. I will now run a simple program I wrote in order to light up this LED. Cool, isn't it? But very useful as well. Let's see how we can achieve that. Secure Cell or SSH is a cryptographic network protocol to allow remote login to other network services to operate securely over an unsecured network. Using SSH, we can remotely log in to a system and execute commands. In this case, the system we want to log into is the Raspberry Pi. SSH protocol allows us to gain access to the command line of the Raspberry Pi from another computer, but only on the same network. Let's now see how to set up our systems in order to achieve that. SSH is built into the Raspbian distribution that we are using, so all we have to do is to set up the network connection for our Raspberry Pi board. I am using a Raspberry Pi A+ today, but you can use any Raspberry Pi board you like. I replaced the big Wi-Fi dongle I was using so far with this tiny and cheap one I got from gearbest.com. It is working fine and it is plug and play, there is no need to install anything at all. It makes things more compact. You can find a link for it in the description of the video. All we have to do now is to boot the Raspberry Pi once and set up the Wi-Fi password. Next, we have to run the command sudo ifconfig in order to get the IP address of our Raspberry Pi. Note this address as we are going to need it. In my case, the address is this. Most routers assign a different IP address each time we connect our Raspberry Pi board to the network, so we have to make the IP address of the Raspberry Pi a static one. In order to achieve that, I logged in my router settings page and defined that I want my Raspberry Pi board to have a specific IP address. This one. Check your router settings and see how to set your Raspberry Pi to have a static IP. Next, let's go to the computer. At first, we have to download the PuTTY SSH client. I am using a Windows operating system, so I am downloading PuTTY for Windows. After running PuTTY, we have to enter the IP of the Raspberry Pi. We press Save in order PuTTY to remember the IP address and we press the Open button. We get a warning message the first time we connect, but we can ignore it. Next, we have to log in to Raspberry Pi with username PI and password Raspberry. Please note that as you type the password, nothing appears on the screen. It is a security feature of Linux. That's it, we are connected to the Raspberry Pi. We can type any command we like in the terminal. Check this out, I have developed a small Python program that turns on an LED and another one which turns it off. So, I can now remotely execute the programs and turn the LED on or off. We can achieve the same thing on our cell phone as well. If you use an Android device, you can download Juis SSH application, which is an SSH client just like PuTTY. You have to configure it first, just like we did with PuTTY, and then you can access your Raspberry Pi via your cell phone. This way, we can remotely work on our Raspberry Pi without having to use a keyboard, a mouse or a monitor for the Raspberry Pi board, just a cheap Wi-Fi dongle. I use this method all the time when I develop software for the Raspberry Pi, since I can work on my desktop computer. Are you going to use this method in order to connect to your Raspberry Pi remotely? If yes, how do you plan to use it? Please post your comments and ideas in the comment section below. Also, consider voting on the project you would like me to work on next in the website educates.tv/ideas. It will help me decide which projects are more interesting to you the viewers of the channel. Thank you. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, and build.